Hi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will try to explain the similarities and differences between the motor effect and generator effect. I hope that you watch the videos about the motor effect and generator effect from my YouTube channel. If not, please take a look and gain basic knowledge about the motor effect and generator effect. Maybe the best way to start is with the definitions of the motor effect and generator effect. The motor effect is the term used when a current-carrying wire in the presence of a magnetic field experiences a force. The generator effect is the effect whereby a wire or coil moving in a magnetic field generates an induced potential difference or induced current. As we see from the definitions, these two effects serve different functions, but there's a similarity in the principle. In fact, there's similarity from a construction point of view. Both the motor effect and generator effect require a magnetic field to happen. Armature is used to achieve the effect in both cases. The armature must carry current, so it's always a conductor or a conductive coil. The armature's role is twofold. The first is to carry current across the field, and the second role is to generate an electromotive force, EMF. As we say, these two effects serve different functions, and they have a lot of differences. The key differences are: in the case of the motor effect, electric energy is the input and mechanical energy is the output. Let's clarify. When we put a current-carrying wire in the magnetic field, this current-carrying wire experiences a force. In case of generator, mechanical energy is the input and electric energy is the output. Let's clarify. If we move the wire through the magnetic field, or if we move magnets into the coil of wire like shown, then a potential difference is induced across the ends of the wire. Or, if we have a complete circuit, then in this circuit we induce current. The motor effect follows Fleming's left-hand rule. How can we use Fleming's left-hand rule? First, place your thumb, first finger and second finger so they were at right angles as shown. Now point your first finger in the direction of the magnetic field from north to south. Now point your second finger in the direction of the conventional current, in other words, positive to negative terminal. Finally, the direction that your thumb is pointing shows you the direction of the motion of the wire. In other words, direction of the force. The generator effect follows Fleming's right-hand rule. How can we use Fleming's right-hand rule? First, place your thumb, first finger and second finger in such a way that they are mutually perpendicular to each other. We have to apply the right hand in such a way that your thumb points in the direction of motion of the wire. Your forefinger points in the direction of the magnetic field. Then, the second finger gives you the direction of the induced current. A better way could be if we show examples of the motor effect and generator effect. An example of the motor effect is an electric car or bike where the electric current is applied to the machine or device, and it gets converted into mechanical motion, and as a result, the car or bike moves. The example of the generator is that in power stations, the turbine is used as a device which converts mechanical energy or force of water falling from the dam to generate electric energy. I hope that you now know what is the difference between the motor effect and the generator effect. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share this video. Watch the rest of my videos on my YouTube channel. Please consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.